and in terms of personal income tax rates. So that's the framework we operate within.
That from a petroleum point of view, you've created a level playing field for both onshore and offshore development, which is what the industry wanted. You then come back to iron ore, which is principally Western Australia, with some smaller reserves in places such as Northern Territory, South Australia. You go to coal, you're principally focused on Queensland and New South Wales. So we're down to a couple of hundred companies, as against many thousands. Those reasons we have established a policy transition to be led by Don Argus and myself. In terms of any outstanding detail of the responsibility of that committee, you actually screwed the application of the proposed tax system. With respect to One Steel, the key point from day one has been where you establish the tax system. We've actually taken it to mine gate. We then go to actually applying these principles, for example, my opinion, on the basis of my reading of these principles, there is no danger to any jobs in South Australia. We'll see the expansion of Olympic Dam, which is going to create a huge economic opportunity for South Australia and the nation, and will secure the future of all those workers and their families who depend on One Steel.
That's
the
same world. Prime
Minister, you've effectively broken the 2007 election by dumping the resource exploration rebate, which replaced the flow through share schemes that the Labor offered in opposition. Now, this is a classic case of the government carrying to big miners, the big northern miners, at the expense of the small in the town.
Firstly, on the resource exploration incentive that we announced a couple of months ago, the industry decided to ditch it. We ditched it because the industry wants to ditch it. Let's be a little bit practical about why.
In terms of where we go
from here, it will be part of consideration of any other possible system for implementation of the chair by Don Argus and myself.
Okay.
Yeah,
on
superannuation, I guess
this
is probably for the Treasurer. Ken Henry, in his appearance with the Senate Estimates Committee last month, said that the increase in superannuation from 9% to 12% would ultimately
well, it will depend upon savings, which can assist this country to fund the economic prosperity and investment that we are going to experience through mining boom Mark II. So boosting national savings is absolutely fundamental to maximising the opportunities, particularly the jobs and the wealth creation that will come through the higher terms of trade that we're going to experience as a result of being in the Asian century.
Prime Minister, this is obviously a very different tax to the one you started with. Is this where